Welcome back to our discussion of the new Lab 1, Part C, Introduction to the ArcGIS Project. So, we've downloaded some data, and then we figured out how to log in and actually start the software. Now we're going to do a little bit inside of ArcGIS Pro. Again, these walkthroughs aren't always intended to go through every part of the lab walkthrough, because most of the fun is doing it yourself, but to show a little bit of the highlights here. And some of the highlights here with working inside of ArcPro are just some of the UI stuff. User interface, maybe a little UX to user experience. This is where we left off last time. We have signed in to ArcGIS Pro. I am still using it here on the remote desktop. Hence why I've got a computer in a web browser. Pretty exciting. I've unzipped my data. Here it is on the desktop hanging out. And I've opened Arc. And again, I've signed in. Lots of different options here of how to start Arc. And if you're looking at this and noticing, wait, my Arc looks just a little different, that's because on the virtual drive, we're running Arc 2.9.5. The download we've prepared for everybody is version 3. That's what's available for download. So they look a little bit different. And there is the smallest difference in terms of capabilities, but that's noted in the walkthrough. So it's not actually not anything that's going to break our game here. Well, Arc works on that geoprocessing cache. See how long that takes. A couple of options here for how we start up Arc Pro, how we work with Arc Pro here. And what you'll see is that you can create all of these, what are essentially templates, what are essentially ways of working with data. In future labs, we will start with maps, but for now, we're going to start without a template. We're going to start without a template because there's so much going on anyway that we, let's just start blank. And it is very blanket. It is very stark. There's nothing on here. So we're just going to kind of add a couple things in piece by piece. First, we're going to start with a map because we have no map. We just have a bunch of blank panes. We're going to start with a new map. When that new map opens, it's going to pop us right onto UMass's campus. There it goes. And we can do all the usual things that you could do with a map, just like any other map. Zoom out, scroll around. This is one of those places where if you are working on the virtual desktop, this is where the plugged-in internet connection makes your life great. Because all this base map information, this isn't saved anywhere on a computer. It's all streaming. So really, should always be working with a plugged-in internet connection and GIS. It makes your life a lot nicer. The lab document walks you through a little bit to make. You can see that names of buildings pop up as you zoom in and out. And I believe that the lab document then eventually asks you to make a little map of the campus pond and library and the morals, so on and so on. It's all pretty easy to manage. One of the key things in working with Arc is, well, first of all, there's these great keyboard controls. Just tap Alt. All these keyboard controls show up. So if you like being a keyboard control person, you've got all those options. Another thing is that Arc loves a right click. Lots of functionality, lots of things that you can do with the program are hidden in a right click. There we go. Look at that. Look at all that stuff I can do. I can basically do whatever I want in here. Well, not whatever I want, but I can do a lot of interesting stuff. And for the first part of the lab, you'll make a certain view of campus and you'll capture it to the clipboard, paste it into your lab document. Easy. One of the other things that we do in part C here is change the look. This is a great descriptive base map. Maybe we want something more fun. Maybe we want to see, oh, let's try, is it, I'm always a fan of, OpenStreetMap, that's cool. Terrain with labels, image, let's try imagery hybrid. I wonder what that means. There you go. Now I have imagery. I can see stuff. I can take a peek at my cars on this map. Anyway, right? You can use this imagery and just have a field day. All of these different base maps provide you with different ways of looking at the data, understanding what's going on. It's similar to our first one, except it's emphasizing terrain. You can see building outlines in the terrain. That's pretty cool. We zoom out to some mountains. There's the Catskills. That's actually pretty neat. That's pretty cool. What else do we have on here? OpenStreetMap. OpenStreetMap is an open source data project, I guess is a good way of putting it. You've probably seen OpenStreetMap data before and maybe not even known it. And here's campus. Here's that. Everything's so nice. All these little paths are on here. That's great. Cafe. Very neat. Scroll to your town. Wander around the map. See what kind of stuff is going on. That's part of the whole experience of working with GIS data, is kind of seeing what's around you, seeing what is of interest. This one, I'm not sure I like this one that much. It gets better when you zoom in, though. In any case, Part C has you play around with some data, play around with some base maps, do some captures, just make some quick little snippets of maps. Shows you how to use the snipping tool, a better way of capturing things like user interface stuff. The snipping tool is a great thing to use when you have errors, when you have issues, when you have problems with GIS. It is so much easier for me or anyone you might be working with to diagnose what a problem is. If you include a screenshot or a snip of what that problem is. Perfect. So play around with your screenshots, play around with your base maps and whatnot. That'll get you through Part C and on to the next.